In today's video, I am going to explain how I see human body. I sometimes see human body as layers, mass of layers. If you understand today's anatomy, you can apply today's info for stretching, yoga, Pilates, athletic performance, and for therapeutic situations. You are looking core muscles. Of course, you can apply today's info for chest, shoulder, hip, and pelvis. So, core is easy to understand today's concept. You are looking core muscles, but in human body, our body is covered by what? Skin, right? Skin is the outermost layer of human body, and if you dissect skin, there is fat, that is adipose tissue. Adipose tissue. There you see core muscles. This one is external oblique. External oblique, this is the outermost core muscle. And this is on right side. You don't see external oblique. Right side external oblique is dissected. Then you see internal oblique. Internal oblique. So external oblique, the outermost core muscle. Internal oblique is one layer deeper. And of course, there are other core muscles. Now in this picture, external oblique and internal oblique are reflected. They are gone. Now we see two core muscles. This one is the most famous core muscle. This is rectus abdominis. Let me add on this part. Rectus abdominis. Rectus abdominis plus you see this one. This is also core muscle. This is transverse abdominis. Transverse abdominis. See, you have many layers in core muscles. Again, you have skin, outermost layer, then adipose tissue. Then you finally see core muscles. External oblique, internal oblique, rectus abdominis, and transverse abdominis. Then there are even deeper muscles. Let's go to deeper abdominal muscle. You see this one. This is psoas. Psoas. Then you see more abdominal muscle. This is quadratus lumborum. Quadratus lumborum. It looks like this is back muscle, but this is considered as abdominal muscle. It's very interesting, right? Anyway, psoas and quadratus lumborum. These are very deep abdominal core muscles. And you don't see some other tissues, but in real human body, there are internal organs in front of psoas and quadratus lumborum. There's like kidney, there's like liver here, there is stomach here, there is large intestine and small intestine. Internal organs are sometimes ignored for exercise and therapeutic situations, but knowing anatomy of internal organ is very important. Why? Let's see if you want to do myofascial release for psoas. Now you have good visualization of psoas in your head, but what if you don't have visualization of internal organs? You may push hard for psoas, but what is actually in front of psoas? Internal organs. Internal organs are very sensitive for kind of a stimulus, right? You don't want to be poked internal organ directly. But if you do not have visualization, maybe your fingers can be very intense. That can be very strong. So you may unconsciously put a lot of stimulus for internal organs. Thus, having visualization of anatomy is very, very important. You can apply this info for exercise if you want to use psoas, and if you are aware there are internal organs, maybe you have good visualization, you have good sense of moving, right? So again, let's go to superficial layer. You have skin, adipose tissue, external oblique, internal oblique, rectus abdominis and transabdominis, then psoas and quadratus lumborum, and plus there are internal organs. Now, this is kind of a lot of things to remember, right? I have good visualization. This is good visualization. This is onion. Outermost layer of onion is literally skin, right? It's like a skin of human. If you peel skin, there's outermost layer. Let's say this is adipose tissue in human body. And if you peel adipose tissue, what's there? Next layer. In this case, that's external oblique. And if you dissect that, you see internal oblique, you see transverse abdominis, rectus abdominis, then internal organs and psoas and quadratus lumborum. But the question is, where is outer muscles? Where is inner muscles? Is there obvious separation in this layer? Probably not. But we tend to prefer to separate outer muscles and inner muscles. Of course, that kind of separation is important to visualize deep muscles and superficial muscles. But in real human body, there's no obvious separation for inner muscles and outer muscles. I like to see human body as mass of layers, so there's no obvious separation for inner and outer. The model is very good. Most common thing is people are not aware there are such inner muscles. Thus, they cannot use deep muscles such as psoas, transverse abdominis, and quadratus lumborum. People are good at using outer part of muscles such as rectus abdominis and external oblique. You know, separation is good to visualize segment. Does it make sense? I want to give you tip to see the human body from different angle. That is layer. Outermost layer, that is skin. Next layer, adipose tissue. Next layer, external oblique, internal oblique. If you know this kind of way to see anatomy, it's gonna give you a new idea to analyze human body. Let's say somebody is not good at using outer muscles and focus for outer layer. Then if somebody is good at using psoas, then focus for deeper layer. I just want to give you a new idea. Of course, you can apply this anatomy for other tissues, such as nervous tissue. What is inside of vertebra? There is spinal cord. If you go superior, there is brain. These tissues are considered as central nervous system, right? Literally in center. Then you have peripheral nervous system, right? You can apply this info for onion model. This is core of onion. Let's say this is brain and spinal cord. There is peripheral nervous system from spinal cord like this. This peripheral nervous system penetrates each layer like this. Then this sends nervous tissue to skin. Of course, nervous tissue is on muscles, joint, and internal organs like this. So core of onion represents brain and spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system penetrates each layer like muscles, bones, skin, internal organs. So you can focus on outer layer and you can focus on middle layer or deeper layer to do stretching, yoga, or manual therapy. Now you can apply the same thing for circulatory system. Let's say there's heart in center of body, there's big artery penetrating muscles, internal organs, and skin, and giving nutrition and oxygen like this. Today's info is not only way to see human body. There are other bunch of models to analyze human body. This is just one of them. But I like this way because human body is very complicated. It's hard to separate each tissue. Of course, separation is good to analyze, good to memorize human body, but human body is integrated structure. It is united structure. So I want to give you new way to look human body. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.